Hello and welcome to the Cat Collective. I'm Nina, I'm the channel for this channel, and let's start. Animals. Oh, and love. Oh. Oh, lovely. I'm gonna put another one. Lighten your load. Okay. So, gonna put some cards of mine and also some cat cards, of course. And then we can start with the reading. Oh, is this going to be a Virgo reading again? I don't know yet. Okay. So, let's see what the cats have to say. I'm getting a lot of mental chatter, mental debris. Cats do have a lesson for you today. I'm very much getting frustration. You're sitting in your dull castle, looking outside, and the landscape also does look like a brown debris. There's nothing much going on, right? It's just brown, dull darkness. Even the tiles look boring. And you're asking yourself, why am I sitting here? You know, what is this all about? I'm sitting here in my bad place, right? Why is nothing changing? Why? And I'm sure you're looking at other people. I'm getting a little bit of... Is it greed? Envy? Envy. I think it's envy. It's a little bit like, look at them. They have got a nice life, right? What do I have, right? And you probably feel like this a little bit. Stuck. There's dirt going on. You don't know what this word is saying. And you're like, come on, bring it on. What's that, right? And I'm sure you're also feeling like look at this, like you're chasing nothing, you are just jumping up and that's that, right? And like this, it seems to me that you're not hitting your target, but you understand that you are the magician and that you are supposed to be able to manifest anything you want with your magical tools, right? And also, you know, look at the wall cavings here, like the wall drawings and all the nice things going on, right? You are supposed to pick a dream, right? Why isn't that working? Right? And I'm sure this very much causes you mental trouble, right? Because you just don't get it, and this person is screaming even. It's just frustration that you cannot leave behind. And your back hurts from all the weight that you carry, you know. And I'm also getting that you are a little bit closed off. Because of this frustration, because if we are looking out and perceiving this as the way it is, right, then it will not change. And I'm sure you you have learned a lesson. Maybe you have had a very special encounter with a otherworldly being. Could, or just with some magic in general, right? And this might have changed a little bit your perception. You know, your eye. Maybe your third eye is now open. Could be. And it could be that before that you probably just saw it in the linear way, and you didn't believe in magic. You didn't believe in otherworldly things, and but your spirit team really wanted you to experience something like this. And this is a card of confusion because you don't know what you can really see in this card. I know what it is. It's a banana. It's supposed to be a banana because I drew it, but you don't know. It could be anything, right? It's just that you had to experience something that was a little bit strange, right? And otherworldly. And this made you realize that you have still to learn some things, and that your perception needs to change. I'm seeing this with the love and animal cards, because this is a more feminine energy and this is very masculine, you know, linear, just logic, and a very strict, straightforward thing. And you, I'm sure you have been open to your feminine side, which is a lot more about feelings and you know, not so linear, it's more flowing, right? And I'm sure this situation has opened you up a little bit more, and you had to experience this, however it applied. I'm sure, I'm really getting that you have had a very special, kind of creepy almost experience with some off-planet energy. Could be anything, basic. I don't want to put a label on this at all because it can play out in so many ways. And I'm sure in the beginning it drove you crazy, but now you are seeing, hey, that's actually quite nice, right? And you are now realizing that you are actually not stuck or in a way surrounded by this, but that you are actually a blank canvas. And you just need to paint yourself, basically, so that you don't chase nothing, just the sky, right? You know that you can pick things. It's just that the attitude has to change sometimes, and that's what I'm pretty much getting. Yeah, that's the next card, the transformation. This encounter has transformed you, and you now know that you need to change your perception. Maybe there was some victim mentality involved in this, where you thought, you know, all the other people, they have nicer lives than I have. And you were just looking at the lack of things, but you have actually need to focus on the things that are going well in your life. You know, I'm also seeing it with this card, where you just can see the darkness, right? And you need to perceive something other than that. You need to perceive the magic and everything, and all the possibilities that can come from a situation where you maybe felt stuck. Maybe you had maybe you had a new start of some sorts, where you had to really start new, and you only saw the negativity in this. Maybe you have you know, had a breakup or something like that, and it really you first just perceive the negativity and all of this, but now you see, hey, look, I'm actually a blank canvas. That's actually a good thing, because now I can dream up my life, and I'm free. You know, that's a very nice card too, if you're free. But if you are chasing something, you don't even know what you're chasing, I think, in this card, you know. But if you just enjoy being free, hey, that's perfect, right? And this will transform you. So it very much feels like a situation where you had a very dark outlook on the world, and you experienced something which opened your feminine side and your heart and everything. And then you realized, hey, that's actually, I'm the magician. I'm supposed to create my own world, and it doesn't happen from a victim mentality. You know, it cannot happen if you just complain. You know, if you complain and that's that, then nothing will change, because you need to actively participate and actively go for it. Otherwise, the blessings will not come in. But hey, look at that, blessings are coming. Because you now, your feminine side now sees that you are the creator. You have to work for it, and you have to go for it. Maybe it's maybe you actually were stuck, but just in your own prison. I'm also getting that you might have been you know, accepting the situation the way it was, without even considering that you are, have the power to change anything. But that's the point. That's the whole point of it. You know, you have the power to create, because the power, the light is in your hands, right? And even though you are naked, you know you can create everything. It just has to come from the right place. And if it doesn't come from the right place, nothing will change, right? So yeah, I love it. So are we supposed to see something more? What's happening next? Or is it just in the ethers? But you know, when you are the creator, you know what you want to create, right? Overflow. Okay. Overwhelm and plenty. Okay, so be assured that once you've got it, you will get too much. And then, you know, sometimes when we have too much, it can also be a little bit overwhelming, right? For me, this is an overall very positive card, because if you have too much, I mean, then at least you can't complain that you have too less, right? But you could complain that you have too much. And it's a perception thing, right? So, love that. From to over, it's too much. I'm gonna pull another one. Okay. Metox. Repairing the body, mind, and spirit. Oh, isn't that lovely? Yeah, see. So you clearly now see that you really need a little bit of a renovation, right? And you know, sometimes it helps if you also clean up your space, like your house, you know, to just, you know, clean your bath before you lay in it, you know, just clean the whole bathroom and make it nice for yourself, so you can actually enjoy it and not just look at, oh, this is dirty or something like that, you know. Or maybe, you know, because if you're living in a cluttered environment and in a not very structured, organized place, however you want to call it, it reflects into the inner world as well. So if you have troubles to actually repair your body, mind, spirit, just, you know, from sitting in the, I'm also seeing this with the clutter here, you know, there's a lot of clutter going on. I mean, it's kind of organized, but here, you know, if you're just sitting in this, try to just, and you have troubles, try to clean up the outside first and sort through things. That's a good step to actually clean it up, and then clean yourself up, and then your mind will change, you know. Seeing this also as dreams, you know, those bubbles. It's funny, there are creatures inside of them. Oh my god, I probably went through a lot of ET experiences. When they even creep up in your bath, look at that. Yeah, those are creatures, aren't they? Yeah, absolutely. So there's one, and then and there's another one. Oh my god. Yeah, well, there's magic in the air, clearly. And it's just that you have to detoxify from yourself, from your own perception and your own dark side, and see them as friends. Look, they are friendly. They are just having a party with you. Okay, it's a little bit weird because you're naked in the bathtub, but look at the magician stuff going around in the head. So It's a clear guidance that you need to work on your perception and your you have had help, you know, with an otherworldly experience, because it opens you up to other things, to magic, to just to look at that, to see that there's more out there than just the normal 3D reality, right? Because this is not really normal in 3D. It's just there's so much more to it. What is this even? Is this a man? Is this the fish thing? I don't know. He looks a bit like a fish to me, but could be anything. Like, it's just the weirdest thing. And yeah, so I'm gonna pull some more cards. It's just amazing. Focus on the positive. Yeah, well, see. There's not much else to add, but of course, that's the whole reading. That's what it's all about. It's about your perception. Your perception had to change from to yay. And then everything changes and you are the magician. And again, I mean, already getting it again. Victim mentality is not the way to go. You need to know that you are the magician. You are you need to pick your dream. Maybe you don't know what you want. It could be also because I'm seeing with those creatures, it's like, you don't know what you want, maybe. But hey, make up your mind. Pick something and work on it. And then you will see what happens, right? Because when you work on it, even if you don't see the evidence yet, the universe will provide and you will get what you want. It's just that you have to do the work. Yeah. Reveal what needs to be seen. Yeah, maybe you have hidden from yourself some parts that you don't want to look at. Could be, you know, that you have some issues with some certain topics. I'm also getting, like, maybe financials. You know, we all have, I think, we all have some financial things going on, you know, where it depends how we have learned to work with it, how we grew up with it. But if we see it as something negative or toxic, or, you know, finances and money, if we see it as something like that, then we will not attract it, because hey, who wants this in their lives, right? It's just that's just an example that I got for its shadow side. I'm sure you are now working through what needs to be seen, and you will succeed with this. It's a given. So, last guidance card. Let's see. Be bold and make the first move. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If you feel stuck, then you might be actually stuck, and you need to make the first move. You need to keep going, otherwise nothing will happen and you will not change. And nothing will change. It will stay the same. It's just that you have to apply your magic to... you have to pick your dream and work on it. And if you do that, everything falls into place. And it's... it always comes from love, you know? It's the love that you give to yourself, to also accept that you deserve what you want, right? You deserve that. You don't need to beat yourself up over things. And, you know, you can just accept love. And maybe that's a thing for you too, where you just rejected it in a way because you couldn't accept it. And therefore, everything will fall into place. Oh, I love that. So I'm gonna pull another card from my deck with the same meaning. And the meaning is, everything is going to be okay. And now I've got two cards left for the zodiac signs. Oh, okay, Virgo here. See, I told you that's a Virgo reading because of the ET presence. I knew it. Oh my God, yeah, sorry if you're creeped out. I hope you're okay. yeah, so I wish you all the best. Additional info is in the litter box below. And yeah, bye bye, bye bye, bye bye.